Good morning. In the last lecture, we completed time dilation, and I think I also told one short tale about time dilation. This is not magic. Scientifically proven outcome of theory of relativity. Our next article, short article is there. I am going to take just 10 to 12 minutes. Velocity addition. To study velocity addition in relativity, let us consider the same figure that we have considered in the last article. Let us consider two frames of reference. Frame of reference S with coordinate axis x, y, z, origin O. Frame of reference S prime with coordinate axis x prime, y prime, z prime, origin O prime. At time t is equal to 0, these two frames of reference are coinciding or each other. X, x prime, y, y prime, z, z prime coinciding, O and O prime also coinciding. Let at time t is equal to 0, the frame of reference S prime starts moving with uniform velocity v away from the frame of reference S in the positive x direction. So now frame S is stationary frame of reference and frame S prime is the frame of reference in uniform motion with constant velocity v along positive x direction. Let us consider a particle. Moving in this direction parallel to x axis as well as x prime axis. Let us consider a particle moving in a direction parallel to x axis and x prime axis. There is no motion of frame S prime along y direction or z direction, and therefore y and y prime, z and z prime coordinates will be same. Y will be equal to y prime, z will be equal to z prime. There will be change in coordinates only along x direction, and therefore coordinate x measured by observer O and coordinate x prime measured by observer O prime will not be same, they will be different. A body or a particle is there this is moving along x direction parallel to axis x prime parallel to axis x. Velocity of this particle is measured by observer O prime, is also measured by observer O. Velocity is measured by O prime, let us consider it as U prime, and the velocity of this particle is measured by observer O may be U. It is moving with velocity V. This is stationary. One particle or one body is there moving in the direction of x axis parallel to x prime as well as x axis. Velocity of this body, this particle is measured by both the observers, and they found that velocity is u observed by one observer, velocity is u prime observed by other observer. This velocity u dash will be dx dash by dt, and this velocity u will be dx by dt, equation 1, equation 2. Velocity of this particle as observed by O prime u dash, that should be dx dash by dt. Velocity of the same particle as observed by O will be u, that will be dx by dt. Let us use inverse Lorentz transformation. Before using inverse Lorentz transformations, let us first have a look at equation 1 and at equation 2. Let us see which coordinates are involved in equation 1 and equation 2. X coordinate, x coordinate, x coordinate in frame of reference S prime, x coordinate in frame of reference S, time coordinate, time coordinate. Actually, here you can have t dash. T prime, time coordinate in frame of reference S prime, t coordinate in frame of reference S. So, we have to consider only two inverse Lorentz transformations, x coordinate and time coordinate. And general equations for these are x is equal to x prime plus vt prime divided by square root of 1 minus v square by c square. Inverse x coordinate, expression for inverse Lorentz transformation for x coordinate. Similarly, equation number 3, not 1. Similarly, the expression for time coordinate according to the inverse Lorentz transformation will be t is equal to t prime plus v x dash by c square divided by square root of 1 minus v square c square, equation number 4. We need dx and dt. We need dx prime and dt prime. To get values of dx, dt, dx prime, dt prime, let us first differentiate equation 3 with respect to x and t, and let us differentiate equation 4 again with respect to x and t. Differentiation of equation 3 will be
dx is equal to dx prime plus v dt prime divided by, this is constant term, there is no change in the constant term, equation number 5. Differentiation of equation 3 will give us equation 5. Let us differentiate equation 4 to get dt is equal to dt prime plus v dx prime divided by c square whole divided by the constant term square root of 1 minus v square by c square, equation number 6. To get equation 2, we have to divide equation 5 by equation 6. So, let us divide equation 5 by equation 6 to get dx by dt is equal to dx prime plus v dt prime divided by 1 minus v square by c square divided by dt dash plus v dx prime by c square divided by 1 minus v square by c square under the square root. This is further. Dividing 5 by 6, we get this thing. This can be solved further. Dx by dt is equal to dx prime plus v dt prime divided by 1 minus v square by c square inside the square root into division, convert this into product, multiplication, into 1 minus v square by c square inside the square root divided by dt prime plus v dx prime divided by c square. This term, these two are identical terms appearing in numerator and denominator, and therefore identically cancels out. And we further get this as equation number 7, dividing equation 5 by 6 and simplifying, we get equation 7, that is dx by dt is equal to dx prime plus v dt prime divided by dt prime plus v by c square into dx prime. Let us divide the numerator and denominator on RHS of equation 7 by dt dash. Let us divide numerator and denominator on RHS of equation 7 by dt prime to get dx prime by dt prime plus v dt prime by dt prime get cancelled. or let me write it at first and then let me cancel. Divided by dt prime by dt prime plus v by c square dx prime by dt prime.
We have divided numerator and denominator by the same term. So there is no change in equation 7. Dt prime, dt prime, dt prime, dt prime. Dt prime, dt prime here will get cancelled. Dt prime get cancelled with dt prime. This dt prime will get cancelled with this dt prime. Okay. And we are left with so finally what we get, dx by dt is equal to dx prime by dt prime plus v divided by 1 plus v by c square dx prime by dt prime. Remind equations 1 and 2 we wrote earlier in this article. U dash, u prime is what? Dx prime by dt prime. So this is u prime, this is also u prime. Equation 2, u is equal to dx by dt. So this will be u. Using equations 1 and 2 in equation 8, it is to be replaced by u. This, it is to be replaced by u prime. This, it is to be replaced by u prime. With this replacement, using equations 1 and 2 in 8, we further have u is equal to u prime plus v divided by 1 plus v by c square into u prime, equation number 9. U, the velocity of the particle as observed by observer O in the frame of reference. Yes. U prime, the velocity of the same particle as observed by the observer O prime in frame of reference S prime. V, velocity of the frame of reference S prime. C, velocity of light. For time being, let me assume that. For time being, let me assume that U prime, the velocity of the particle as observed by observer O prime, let it be c. Velocity v with which the frame of reference S prime moving, let it be also equal to c, the velocity of light. So when I assume the frame of reference S prime is moving with v which is equal to c, velocity of light, when I assume the velocity of the particle as measured by O prime in S prime, this u prime is also equal to c. Let us assume that u prime be equal to c and this v be also equal to c. Equation number 10. when we can assume these things, we can assume these things if the frame of reference S prime is moving with velocity of light c, and the velocity of the particle as measured by the observer O prime is also equal to c. In that case only we can assume equation 10. Let us put equation 10 back into equation 9 to get u is equal to c plus c divided by 1 plus c by c square into c, that is equal to 2c divided by c square plus c square divided by c square. This is equal to 2c divided by 2c square divided by c square, that is 2c divided by 2, because this c square get cancelled. Finally, this 2 get cancelled, and we are only left with this equation number 11, u is equal to c. What does this mean? If you add any velocity with the velocity of light, the result is always equal to velocity of light. Let us suppose that you have two bodies. These two bodies are moving with two different velocities. One body is moving with 50 km per hour, other body is moving with 50 km per hour. If we add these two velocities, the velocity will be equal to 100 km per hour. If we try to do these things here, what we see? Whenever we add any velocity in the velocity of light, the result is always c. It means that the maximum attainable velocity in the whole universe is c. Nobody can attain a velocity greater than c. If you add anything in velocity of light, the addition will be at the most velocity of light. It will not be more than velocity of light. Numerically, you can add c plus c, 2c. 2c, it is 3 lakh kilometer per second, because c is 3 lakh kilometer per second. 2c, it will be 6 lakh kilometer per second. Algebraically, you can do this numerical calculation. But in practice, physically, it is not possible. Physically, c plus c is c. C plus c plus c, go on adding many times, the result will be only c. In practice, physically, when we add any velocity to the velocity of light, the maximum attainable velocity is simply equal to velocity of light. Nobody can attain a velocity more than velocity of light. Velocity of light c is the highest attainable velocity in the whole universe. This is about the velocity addition in relativity according to the invariance of velocity of light. Hope you got it. It's very simple. Thank you.